Hello everyone, I am Professor Shruti Dixit, Assistant Professor in Electronics and Communication Department, Sagar Institute of Research and Technology, Bhopal. Today we are going to discuss about the topic Embedded System Architecture. This is the fourth unit of subject Microcontroller and Embedded System. This is the syllabus of this fourth unit, Embedded System Architecture. We will discuss here von Neumann and Hardware Architecture, CISC and RISC Machines, Instruction Set Architecture, Basic Embedded Processor, Microcontroller Architecture, then CISC and RISC, Complex Instruction Set Computer, Reduced Instruction Set Computers. Examples are 8051, Advanced RISC Machine, ARM Processor and DSP Processor. This is the whole syllabus of this fourth unit. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss about the von Neumann architecture and Hardware architecture. This is the basic block diagram of both architectures, von Neumann as well as Hardware architecture. In this von Neumann architecture, the basic building blocks are memory, CPU, input and output devices in von Neumann machine as well as in Hardware machine. But the basic difference between these two machines are, in case of von Neumann machine, only there is a single bus for sharing of this data as well as program. Both the data as well as program are stored in the memory. But in case of Hardware machine, there are separate memories are available for storing the program as well as data. So there are separate buses for program as well as data. So this is the basic difference, but in detail, we will discuss the basic differentiation between this von Neumann as well as Hardware model. First of all, we will get the basic overview about the von Neumann machine. Von Neumann machine architecture is named after the mathematician and early computer scientist John von Neumann. This architecture is also known as Princeton architecture. These machines have shared signals and memory for code as means for program as well as data. Same common bus is there, and common memory is for program as well as data. So in case of von Neumann machine, the program can be easily modified by itself since it is stored in the read-write memory. The computer has single storage. As I have told you, the computer has single storage, means single memory for both data as well as program to be executed. It requires two clock cycles to complete an instruction. In case of von Neumann machine, pipelining. The meaning of pipelining is means execution of multiple instruction at the same time. Here, due to the one basic drawback, there is a single memory for storing data as well as program. That's why the pipelining of instruction means execution of this instruction, multiple instructions at the same time, is not possible in case of von Neumann machine. What is happening? It requires, as I have told you, it requires two clock cycles. In the first clock cycle, the processor gets the instruction from the memory. First, the instruction will be fetched from the memory and then decodes it. And in the next clock cycle, the required data is taken from the memory. For each instruction, this cycle repeats, and hence two clock cycles are needed for completion of an instruction. This machine was first invented, and it is relatively older architecture, and this machine was replaced by this new architecture, which is known as Hardware architecture. This is the basic diagram of von Neumann architecture. The basic building blocks required for this von Neumann machine are input devices, output devices, in central processing unit, two units are there, control unit, arithmetic logic unit, and memory unit. The input devices to give the input to the machine, for example, keyboard is the input device. Then output device means display devices, printer is the output device. Then the control unit is used to control all the instructions, and arithmetic logic unit is to perform arithmetical as well as logical instructions, and or addition, subtraction, both types of instructions are executed in this arithmetic logic unit. And memory unit is used to store the data as well as program. And there is a common bus. So there are three important components: central processing unit, memory unit, and input-output interfaces. CPU means central processing unit, which is the heart of the computer system, that consists of three main components, as we have seen in the diagram: arithmetic and logic unit, control unit, and registers. Registers is to use to store the 1-bit data. The ALU is responsible for carrying out all arithmetic as well as logical operations. And this control unit determines the order of flow of instruction that need to be executed in programs by issuing control signals to the hardware. Registers are the temporary storage locations that store addresses of the instruction that need to be executed. One bit instruction is stored in these registers. Memory unit consists of RAM, which is the main memory used to store the program data and instruction. Input-output interfaces allows the user to communicate with the outside world, such as storage devices. And all these units are connected via the buses. In case of hardware architecture, the name hardware architecture comes from the hardware mark first relay-based computer. There is a separate storage for both program as well as data. In case of von Neumann machine, there is a single bus to fetch the instructions from the memory. But in case of hardware architecture, there is a separate memory for data as well as instruction. And it is possible in case of hardware architecture, it is possible to access program memory and data memory. Program memory as well as in data memory simultaneously. Both the concepts are similar except the way they access the memories. The idea behind the hardware architecture is to split the memory into two parts, one for storing of data and other for storing of program. These nowadays, all the computers are designs are actually based on this modified hardware architecture, and commonly used this hardware architecture is commonly used in microcontrollers as well as DC, digital signal processing. Program memory is read only and the data memory is read write. Therefore, it is impossible for program contents to be modified by the program itself. This is the hardware architecture. As we can see in this diagram, separate memories for storing data as well as instruction. All these components, four components: arithmetic logic unit, data memory, input output device, and instruction memory are connected. All our four components are connected to this control unit via the different buses, bidirectional buses. the main function of the bus is to carry the information from one building block to the another building block, or you may call it as a one component to the another component. This is the differentiation between the hardware architecture as well as von Neumann architecture. As I have told you, this von Neumann architecture is older one, and it was replaced by this newer one, which is hardware architecture. Single memory is used for storing both data as well as program. But in case of hardware architecture, separate memories, means RAM as well as ROM, random access memory and read-only memory. In case of arrangement, means this point we point of comparison, first point of comparison is arrangement. Arrangement in case of hardware architecture, the CPU is connected with both the data memory and program memory separately. And in case of von Neumann architecture, there is no separate data and program memory. Single memory connection is given to the CPU. Hardware requirements. It requires more hardware because separate buses are there. So obviously more connection wires, connecting wires, or you may call it as a buses. Bus requirement is more because there is a separate memory for storing data as well as program. But in contrast to the hardware architecture, there is single memory in case of von Neumann architecture. Hence, less hardware is required. And only a common memory needs to be reached. Space requirements, more space is required in case of hardware architecture, but in case of von Neumann architecture, less space is required. Speed of execution. Obviously, there is a separate arrangement of memory for storing of data as well as program. So the speed of execution is ultimately faster because the processor fetches data and instructions simultaneously. But this is not possible in case of von Neumann architecture. Speed of execution is slower because it cannot fetch the data and instructions at the same time, because first it will fetch the data, and then the after fetching of the data, then instructions are executed. Space usage. Here, in case of hardware architecture, this is the biggest disadvantage of this architecture, is that it results in wastage of space. Since if the space is left in the data memory, then the instruction memory cannot use the space of the data memory, and vice versa, due to the separate arrangement of storing data as well as instruction. Here, the space is not wasted because the space of the data and memory can be utilized by the instruction memory, and vice versa. Controlling, due to the separate arrangement of memory, the controlling becomes complex, since the data and instructions are to be fetched simultaneously. But in case of von Neumann architecture, the controlling becomes simpler, since either data or instruction are to be fetched at a one by one, not simultaneously. First the data will be fetched and then instructions are executed. So in this way, we can differentiate between both architectures, hardware architecture and von Neumann architecture. In the next video, we will discuss about the complex instruction set computers, reduced instruction set computers, and ARM processor and DSP processor. So this is all about the von Neumann architecture and Harvard architecture. Thank you.